of the transistor, the vacuum tubes were introduced. Okay, so what are the advantages of this transistor over the vacuum tubes? So this transistor, it is very smaller and light, it is lightweight, and it has no heater requirement or heater loss, and it is construction. Regarding the construction, it is rugged construction, and it is more efficient since less power is absorbed by the device itself. So, and it has got low operating voltage. These are the few advantages over the vacuum tubes. Okay, so as I have discussed, three terminal devices are far more useful than the two terminal ones, such as diodes, because they can be used in a multitude of applications ranging from signal amplification to the design of logic, digital logic and memory circuits. Okay, so this transistor, which will be used in the construction of the digital ICs, integrated circuits. Okay, and then the basic principle involved is the use of voltage between two terminals to control the current flowing in the third terminal. Mainly, we are going to controlling the current flowing in the third terminal. So the transistor, which is a three terminal device, as I told, so we are providing voltage between the two terminals by then controlling the current flowing in the third terminal. This is a basic principle involved in the BJT. In this way, three terminal device can be used to realize a controlled source. So controlled signal can be used to cause current in the third terminal to change from zero to a very large value, thus allowing device to act as a switch. So this transistor, mainly two applications are there. Either we can use the transistor as a switch, or we can be used for the amplification. So either transistor acts as a switch or it acts as a amplifier. That depends upon various modes of operation of the transistor that we are going to see later. So for time being, you consider now a transistor as a switch. As a switch is the basis for the realization of logic inverter. That is nothing but logic inverter is a basic element of the digital circuit. Okay. So next slide, we are going to see the device structure and the physical orientation. Okay. So device structure, here I have considered both the types of transistor, NPN transistor and the PNP transistor. In case of transistor is a three layer device consisting of either two N types. See the first figure, it is a NPN transistor, and the second figure is a PNP transistor. In case of NPN transistor, two N types are there and one P type. P type is sandwiched between two N type. So here, whatever the capital letters abbreviations are given over here. So this terminal is nothing but the emitter terminal, and this one is base, and this terminal, it is a collector. And whatever the dark black line it is given over here, okay, these three dark lines, it is nothing but it is a metal contact. Okay, and this particular NPN transistor, which has got two PN junctions, the first PN junction, that is between the emitter region and the base region, it is called emitter base junction. Who is that drawing in between? So this emitter and base junction, first junction, and the next junction, it is formed between collector and the base, which is called collector base junction. So I can conclude this as the transistor is a three terminal device which is consisting of two N type and one P type. P type is sandwiched between two N types. So N type, this is emitter terminal, this is a base, and this is a collector, which has got two different junction, emitter base junction and the collector base junction. Similarly, PNP transistor, one N type is sandwiched between two P types. Okay, here also three terminals, emitter, base, collector, and these indicates it is a this dark line indicates it is a metal contact we can make from this particular side of the terminals. Okay, so next is the emitter layer. This emitter layer, regarding the doping level, I'm saying this is regarding the doping level, that is adding the impurities. So the emitter layer is heavily doped. Okay, emitter layer is heavily doped than the collector, whereas base is very lightly doped, collector is moderately doped. When I see the physical dimension, I mean the size of the regions, the collector region is very much larger than the emitter and the base. Base is very much smaller than the emitter and the collector. So emitter is heavily doped, this is lightly doped, and this is moderately doped. And the physical size, when I say collector is larger in size than emitter and base is very much smaller in size. Okay, and next is, when I say doping level, if the doping level is low, means what about the conductivity? Conductivity will be less. Okay, if the doping level is high, means the conductivity is more. Indicates that conductivity less means which increases the resistance. Conductivity is more means decreases the resistance. So the three terminals are indicated now: emitter, collector, and the base. Yeah. Okay. The term bipolar, as I told, it is a bipolar device. The term bipolar reflects the fact that holes and electrons participate in the injection process into the oppositely polarized material. So if only one carrier is employed, it is considered as unipolar. Means it is, example, we can consider diode. And then transistor has got two different junctions, emitter base junction and the collector base junctions. So depending on the bias condition, that is either forward biased or reverse biased, of each of these junctions, different modes of operation of VGTs are obtained, which is shown in the next table. We are going to see that. Okay. So depending upon these two junctions, whether it is forward biased or reverse biased, VGT can enter into three different modes. Okay, before to this, the explanation is given over here. You can see here, VGT consists of a semiconductor regions, emitter region, base region, collector region. Such a transistor is called NPN transistor, which is exactly opposite than this. We call it as a PNP transistor. Three terminals are emitter, base, collector, and two junctions, emitter base junction and the collector base junction. Then the active mode is a one. I told the VGT can enter into three different modes. That is, one is active mode, next is a cutoff mode, and one more is the saturation mode. So active mode is the one which is used if the transistor is to operate as an this is a table which shows BJT modes of operations. So you can see here three different modes are there: cutoff mode, active mode, and the saturation mode. So two junctions, emitter base junction and collector base junction. So depending upon the bias condition of these two junctions, the BJT can enter into these three modes. Okay, I told already the application of the transistor. Transistor can act as a switch or it can act as a amplifier. So whenever the transistor, it is in cutoff and the saturation, the transistor is acting as a switch. Whenever the transistor is in active mode, it is acting as an amplifier. So in the cutoff mode, emitter base junction will be reverse biased. Both the junctions will be reverse biased. Saturation, both will be forward biased. And active means emitter base junction is forward biased and collector base junction will be reverse biased. Now we are seeing transistor as an amplifier. So we need to operate the transistor in the active mode. Active mode means we need to make emitter base junction as forward biased and collector base junction as a reverse biased. Are you getting my point? We are going to see now transistor as an amplifier. Amplifier means which will operate in the active mode. Active mode means I have to make emitter based junction as forward bias and collector based junction as a reverse bias. Again, that depends upon whichever the transistor we take, NPN and PNP. Okay, so next slide, we are going to see operation of NPN transistor in the active mode. So we are taking here NPN transistor in the active mode. Active mode, what is the condition? Emitter base junction should be forward biased. Forward biased in the sense, when I say forward biased, N-type, this terminal should be connected to your negative potential. And P-type should be connected to the positive potential. Then only your emitter base junction will get forward biased. And I have to make collector base junction as a reverse biased. When it will get reverse biased? When I give the positive potential to the N-type and negative potential to the P-type, right? So this is the condition for, this is the condition for condition for the active mode. Okay, so here VBE stands for, see this VBE VCB stands for external DC biasing, means we are providing some external DC supply to the transistor. Okay, that is to make emitter base as forward biased, collector base as reverse biased. Understood? So here I told, see, N-type means, which is a majority charge carrier? Electrons. P-type means the majority charge carrier will be holes. Again, N-type, electrons will be the majority charge carriers. Now, as I told, transistor is a transferring the resistance from low resistance to high resistance. So, from the N-type emitter, the electrons will be emitted and it will pass through the base region. It will pass through the base region. And it will be collected at the collector region. So that is why the names are given like this. Emitter, which emits the electrons, and base, which passes the electrons to the collector. Collector, which will collect the electrons. Okay. There are actually two components. Two current components are there. One is because of... please mute your audio buttons, otherwise it will be a disturbance. No one can hear whatever I'm explaining. Okay, so two external voltage sources are used to establish the required bias condition for active mode of operation. What is the required bias condition? One is emitter based junction is forward biased, collector based junction should be reverse biased. Okay, so next is a forward bias or on condition established by applying the, yeah, this I have told, that is negative potential to the N-type and positive potential to the P-type. Similarly here. So the application of the forward bias potential VBE will pressure the electrons in the N-type material and hole in the P-type material to recombine with the ions near the boundary. And which will reduce the width of the depletion region. See, you know, across this, I mean, in this junction, there will be a region called depletion region. So when there will be a forward bias, means the depletion region width, it decreases. So as we increase this potential, the depletion region width, it decreases. Okay, because this is forward bias. Similarly here, this is reverse bias. So depletion region width here, it is increases as we increase here potential, depletion region width increases. Okay, so that is regarding the depletion region. Now, the forward bias on emitter based junction will cause current to flow in this, across this junction. Current will consist of two components. I was discussing this only. Current will consist of two components. One is electrons injected from the emitter to base, and holes injected from base to emitter. See here, electrons injected. See this direction mark. Electrons injected from emitter to base, and one more direction is the reverse direction. That is because of holes injected from base to emitter. So current flow because of this electrons, and here that is because of the holes. Right. So, two current components are there. So, why we are not considering this current direction is because the base is very lightly doped, isn't it? So minority charge carriers, it will be very less. That is why we will be considering only this direction current flow. So it is highly desirable to have the first component at a much higher level than the second component. This can be accomplished by fabricating the device with heavily doped emitter and lightly doped the base. That is, device is designed with high density electrons in the emitter and low density holes in the base. Okay, and then direction of the current, it is moving away from the emitter terminal. So the direction of IE is like this. Okay, this is the direction of electron, this direction of the charge, it is opposite to that current flow. So it is away from the emitter terminal. Okay, so next is next slide explanation. Whatever I have done till now, it has been given. Voltage VBE causes p-type base to be higher in potential than the n-type emitter, thus forward biasing the emitter base junction. Collector base voltage VCB causes n-type collector to be higher potential than p-type base, thus reversing the collector base junction. Forward bias on the emitter base junction will cause current to flow across this junction. Current will consist of two components, as I told. First one is electrons injected from emitter to base, and next is holes injected from base to emitter. It is desirable to have first component at a much higher level than the second component because emitter is heavily doped than the base. Okay, next is direction of current. As I told, direction of current IE, it is out of emitter lead, which following the usual convention, it is in the direction of the direction of the positive charge flow, that is hole current, but opposite to that of the direction of the negative charge flow, that is opposite to the direction of the electron. Okay, so with the emitter current IE being equal to the sum of these two components, means IE it is because of majority as well as the IE is nothing but IE of because of majority as well as because of the minority charge carriers. However, since electron component is much larger than the hole component, emitter current will be dominated by the electron component only. Okay, so majority is here electron, minority carrier is holes. So we are not considering majority, will be dominated by the minority charge carrier. So we will be considering only the majority. Okay, so now for time being, let us consider the electrons injected from emitter to base. Okay, so these electrons will be electrons will be minority carriers in the p-type base region. Because the base is usually very thin in the steady state, the excess minority carrier concentration in the base will have an almost straight line profile. You see this picture. See here, this is NPN transistor. This is VB and VCB. External biasing is provided. And in this figure, you can see this portion, it is emitter portion. And this dotted line, within the dotted line, it is nothing but the depletion region. And here, this is the base region. And these between these two dotted lines, it is the collector to base junction. And thereafter, it is a collector region. Okay. So whatever the curves it is given over here, or the straight line which is given over here, it is nothing but the electron and the hole concentration. So in case of emitter, majority charge carrier is electron. This curve, it shows the hole concentration. So at the beginning, at this terminal of the emitter, hole concentration is very less. So as the emitter terminal, length of the emitter terminal, when I go this side, what happens? Your hole concentration increases. Means near the depletion region, hole concentration is more compared to this particular region. Okay, and then when I say electron concentration, in case of base, majority is holes, minority is electrons. So in this junction, that is emitter base junction, electron concentration is more compared to the collector base depletion region. So this NP of zero stands for electron concentration at the emitter base junction. Okay, junction. So here it is almost zero. Understood? Only that much. And this is the effective base width, the W. Okay, W it is given. So this along the y-axis, it is given carrier concentrations. Carrier concentration. Okay. So now, so here NP naught. So here you see this expression NP of zero. That is the electron concentration at this particular junction, that is emitter base junction, it is given as NP naught of e to the power VBE divided by VT, where VBE is the this voltage, okay, and NP naught, which is the thermal equilibrium value of the minority carrier concentration in the base region, and then VT is the thermal voltage, which is equal to the approximately equals to 25 millivolt at room temperature. The reason for the zero concentration at the collector side of the base is that positive collector voltage VCB causes electrons at that end to be swept across the collector base junction depletion region. That is why the electron concentration at the collector base region, it is zero concentration. So the tapered minority carrier concentration profile causes the electrons injected into the base to diffuse through the base region towards the collector. What they're telling is the whatever the electrons it is injected from emitter to the base here, the recombination again it is going to happen, and whatever the amount of electrons remains after the recombination, that will be collected at the collector terminal. Okay, that will be collected at the collector terminal. So this electron diffusion current IN, it is denoted as IN, diffusion current, is directly proportional to the slope of the straight line concentration profile. That is, it is directly proportional to the straight line diffusion current, IN. So what is it, IN? IN is nothing but AEQDN, DNP of X divided by DX. Or this is equals to this much minus of NP of 0 divided by W. So where AE, see, this is the equation you need to know, because all this I'm doing from Cedra and Smith. These are the basic concepts you require to study the discrete, classical discrete biasing technique, that is voltage divider biasing technique, which is given in your syllabus. So no need to by heart anything from this. Just you need to know all this concept. That's it. Okay, so IN is the diffusion current, which is equals to this much, where A is the cross-sectional area of the base emitter junction and Q is the magnitude of electron charge, and DN is the electron conductivity in the base, and W is the effective width of the base. Okay, some of the electrons that are diffusing through the base region will recombine. As I told, when it passes through the base region, electrons will recombine with the holes present in the base. That is called recombination process. So some electrons will be lost, and whichever the amount of electron it is, electrons we get after the recombination process, that will reach the collector terminal. So nevertheless, the recombination in the base region causes excess minority charged carrier concentration profile to deviate from the straight line and take the slightly concave shape. You can observe here this concave shape, it is given after recombination. Means some electron will be lost after the recombination process. And how much ever the electron will be remaining, that will reach the collector terminal. Okay, so that is about this figure. Next is what happens to the collector current. What is the amount of collector current? How we are going to obtain? You know already the formula. IC, collector current, which is equals to IS e to the power VBE divided by VT, or else the what is IS? IS is nothing but saturation current, which is nothing but your diffusion current. IS or IN, AEQDN, NP naught divided by W. So NP naught, substituting NP naught as Ni square divided by Na, where Ni is the intrinsic carrier density and Na is the doping concentration in the base. So we can express IS as like this. That is replacing NP naught as Ni square divided by Na. I think probably you might have come across this expression. IC is equals to IS e to the power VBA by VT. But you may not be knowing, simply you could have, they could have told what is IS, saturation current. But how did we obtain this? That we have seen today. That is saturation current, which is nothing but the diffusion current. Okay. So in detail it is given. So an important observation you can make here is that the magnitude of IC is independent of VCB, right? The magnitude of IC is independent of, see, the collector current, it is independent of the whatever the voltage we applied for collector base, that is VCB, correct? VCB. That is, as long as collector is positive with respect to base, electrons that reach the collector side of the base region will be swept into the collector and the register as collector current. So collector current, it is independent of the VCB. Saturation current IS is inversely proportional to the base width W and is directly proportional to the area of the emitter base junction. Typically IS value, IS, it is in the range of this much, that is 10 to the power minus 12 amperes to 10 to the power minus 18 amperes. Because IS is proportional to NI square, who is playing in my laptop screen? I want to know that. Who is that? And it is written over here, it is D. Because IS is proportional to NI square, it is a strong function of temperature, approximately doubling for every 5 degrees Celsius rise in the temperature. Okay, so we have seen now collector current. Collector current is IS into e to the power VB divided by VT. Now let us see what is base current. You have already come across this expression, IB is equals to IC by beta, and you know already what is IC. IC is nothing but I. Sorry, IE is nothing but IC plus IB, right? So, see, the base current is composed of, again, two components, IB1 and IB2. So, what is this first component, IB1? It is because of the holes injected from base region to emitter. Okay, next current is, this current component is proportional to this much, e to the power VB divided by VT, to the second component of the base current IB2, which is due to holes that have to be supplied by the external circuit in order to replace holes lost from base through the recombination process. But we will be IB, it is because of these two components, IB1 and IB2. IB2 is proportional to number of electrons injected into the base. It will be proportional to this much. So IB is equals to IB1 plus IB2, which is proportional to, and can be expressed as a fraction of the